Love, one.
So the final of the women's singles. What a week it's been here at this inaugural WTT Champions Frankfurt. Wang Manyu going for her third WTT Champions level title of her career against Wang Yidi, going for a very first.
One call.
The big question coming into this around the fitness of Wang Manyu takes that heavy head-to-head into this. These opening few points are going to be huge in terms of getting, trying to get an early read on this contest. There, that's an early sighter from Wang Yidi.
Amazing timing, gets the dwell on the backhand, full extension cross table, and then look at that with the wide base and balance. Nice transfer of weight through that forehand.
Fraser, so much of the focus on the fitness of Wang Manyu, understandably coming in here to such a big occasion, but just in terms of the match, let's just presume she's there, because she's there, she's out there. She wouldn't be out there if she didn't think she could win. I think that's fair to say. But in terms of the matchup here, what you've seen previously, and what you've seen of both this week here in Frankfurt, what do you see as being the keys here to this final here today?
Well, they're both very similar in terms of service level. Wang Manyu might have the better receive. We're probably going to see lots of backhand-to-backhand rallies, but whoever can switch down the line I see will have the better chance of winning. In addition to that, whoever can play the parallels better has a really good chance. Whoever can pivot and play the forehand. We know that Wang Yidi is normally more backhand-orientated, but she's going to have to step that corner more here against the Asian singles champion if she really wants to impose herself. Wang Manyu protects certain areas so, so well.
Six, one.
Nearly stroke of luck there for Wang Yidi.
So spinny, the net there. So wide. Wang Manyu did well to get bat on ball, but to no avail.
1-7.
Yeah, in an early sense, they're looking back to that previous point, the suggestion, an early examination of her fitness, having to get down to that. Think of the left leg problem, early test. Oh. And it's a real early test here with the start that Wang Yidi is making to this final. What a start it is.
Striking the ball so well, the combinations have been pinpoint, and look at that, there's the parallel. Not an easy shot to play against heavy topspin.
8-2.
She likes to punch quite a lot on the backhand, Wang Yidi, but it's higher risk. The ball's going to have to be more arky for her to do that.
Left. 8-2.
Phenomenal start here.
Yeah, all business. And
nine
again, then,
two.
There for Wang Yidi, easily sent away.
She's exposing that wide forehand, and Wang Manyu isn't able to get there. The footwork of the former world champion isn't looking too good.
Still two.
Two,
there's a point on serve as well there, continuing that run that we demonstrated to you, the numbers firmly in her favour, including most importantly in this first game scoreline. Wang Manyu here, facing down 8 game points.
The change of service there, slightly wider, a lot of backspin.
Can't
save the second, though. This would be her biggest title, no question. And she's off and running in that bid.
Love one.
Juan Manu has had to show powers of resilience through this week, even prior to the leg injury, the road that she's had through. And she's going to need to show that again here. Marlin there, of course, has been coaching, but is not on the benches. That is the way when it's China-China. There are no coaches signed in there. But, of course, he will be a keen spectator here. We all are. I think it's interesting, Fraser, here. Look back on the first game there, what we've seen so far. A bit concerning for supporters of Wang Manyu. Some of the points we saw in that first game. Get a bit more from you on that. She's really going to have to commit more there because, for me, she didn't commit or wasn't able to commit to some of the wide defensive play in that gets in that first game.
She's really struggling to make the forehand counter. She can't cover it as well with that compound movement. I mean, we know she has the wide base anyway to have the balance, but she has to lunge off usually that left leg, which is injured. She's not going to be able to transition
two,
as well.
Three.
She's not going to be able to make the irregular or regular footwork as well, and that really limits the number of ways that she'll be able to win a point. She's going to have to be a lot more divisive and mindful of placement here because she's not going to be able to outpower Wang Yidi. It's what makes that win over Hayata, the biggest threat to Team China and someone only one place below Wang Manyu in the rankings, that much more miraculous that she was able to do it.
Concerned look on a supporter's faces there, and it's understandable what we've seen so far. Yeah, it's something she did. You're talking about the win over Hayata. I suppose what I'd say back to that suggest to you is that was amazing. It showed all of her mental qualities, toughness to come through that. But is there a suggestion here that it's tougher the day after with the injury? You know, in a way she had to mitigate, temper her game against Hayata because the injury struck.
Yeah.
But is it going to be even more difficult here in this occasion a day later?
Late.
Well, even though Hayata is a player that's been able to beat Wang Yidi, I'd say Wang Yidi is slightly the more smarter player. She knows Wang Manyu's game better, sharing the China National Team Training Centre with her day in, day out.
Snaps that away. Beautifully done.
What Wang Manyu is doing better here, though, is she's adjusted her service position to play the shovel from the forehand. That means she can easily, more easily, play the backhand and the third ball and in the rally without having to make as big of an adjustment with the feet. She's trying to dictate the direction of play with her backhand, Wang Manyu.
5-4.
Because she knows she can't play that physical forehand to the same level.
Adjustments you've mentioned that she's having to make, she's being forced to make. It's what makes it all the more impressive here. Out there on the big stage, you've got to make those choices in a split step, in a moment, because if you don't, you're toast.
6-5.
Changing the spin and speed of that one there. Such fine contact. slightly away from the comfort zone can bait your opponent into trying to take on a shot, but make it more difficult for them to produce it with the same quality they're used to.
And there again, as you've been pointing out, the backhand as well is another key part of this adjustment being made by Wang.
It was a great flick. She came right round the side of it. There wasn't so much topspin. And that's why the switch of Wang Yidi went into the net and off.
Eight, six.
Out another point, the former world champion.
Yeah, she actually looks okay on the forearm there. Giving herself more time on the ball by just taking a little bit further distance back.
Seven, nine.
Wang Yidi has lost a few of the last points we've seen. Responding there when she needed to.
I mean, she absolutely obliterated that Wang Manyu, stomped through it, put all the pace on the ball, and it only took a short stroke. What a read, and what a redirection.
Eight, nine.
With this injury, you have to imagine the longer the match goes on, the tougher it's going to be for Wang Manyu.
Yeah, I was about to say that, actually, Fraser. I mean, because, of course, Wang Yidi there, you see the backhand trade. She's kind of backhand-based as well in her game. And going in there into a real strength, Wang Manyu. Just draw an error out of it there. Just enough pace, enough width.
Nice combination into the middle and then slightly wider. You want to get behind that backhand there if you're Wang Yidi, but it's tough to do so.
Two game points then for Wang Manyu here to level up with Wang Yidi.
Wow.
Oh, short game into out there from Wang Yidi. So good.
Nice intricacy, soft hands near the net, and well, she caught that backhand as sweet as nectar. Sizzled it, and the block of Wang Manyu balloons along.
Both game points saved. So here, 2-point clear winning margin needed with the serve alternating this moment to the end of the game. Wang Yidi turns away in frustration. That was an opportunity. She'd opened it up, couldn't finish.
Yeah, Wang Manyu would have been scuppered if that would have gone on. Maybe she thought about the finish line too soon and lost a bit of presence there, Wang Yidi.
Third game point. Just feel like in those moments it can go on and on and on. Such is the quality here of these two elite performers.
Wang Yidi just sat there on the backhand side. Wang Manyu has to find ways to get it away from her racket. Otherwise it's going to be too easy for Yidi to dictate.
11, 12.
You often talk about the sounds of the sport, and it was interesting, the sound there at the end on Wang Manyu's racket was just different there, beaten, not in the sweet spot. So the shots was the shot quality from Wang Yudi. The first game point. Oh, fabulous
13,
finish.
Oh. Love one.
Amazing, isn't it? The reaction time, the wisdom to actually read and understand your opponent's body, what they want of certain shots. Understand how your opponent tries to disguise the direction.
Touch play of Wang Yudi.
Love.
So far, it's been sumptuous.
After each touch, she has to go back to the neutral position, but it's just that shift in body weight and balance to keep it tight with the intricacy.
Three, love.
It's an interesting phrase for a point you make about anticipation. I think the point you were making earlier is interesting here. All the time they've spent playing each other, training with each other, is massive here for Wang Yudi, 7 of the last 8 points in this situation. Because, you know, you look at it in one sense at the head-to-head, we've looked at that. She's lost 5 of the 6 previous meetings. She's lost at this level, including remembering that European Summer Series in a final at the Champions level. But the interesting thing for me is she's known her for a long time. And you go back to the first meeting that they had, the World Junior Table Tennis Championships final, you go the way back. They are contemporaries, really. 2015.
5-1.
One of Wang Manyu's victories, but it's that time, that affinity, that know-how that you can build up about an opponent's game style.
Yeah.
And that can settle you on the big occasion when there are bound to be nerves around. Here, that could be helping Wang Yudi here as well.
Yeah, I feel like she'd be less fearful against Wang Manyu than what Hayata would have been. It's an emotional roller coaster. I mean, you're off the table friends, but on the table foes, so I agree. I feel like there's less likely to be nerves against a teammate because of the implications as well. If you lose to a teammate as a China player, not too deep. If you lose to a foreigner, that could be serious, serious trouble.
3-5.
You've obviously secured the top podium finish, regardless of who wins this. So now they're kind of fighting for more individual pride, in a sense.
Let. 3-5.
Fierce. Fired into her opponent there by Wang Manyu.
It's so difficult to power flick that because it's so top spinny, the way it can kind of skid on the second bounce, and it's so low and tight. You've got to really try and trap the spin, but that's very difficult to do against top spin. You've got to come round the side of the ball more on the touch. If you come right under it, it's going to go really long and high. Opposites in many ways. The more backspin, the more you have to come under it and up the back. The more topspin, the more you got to get over it with a closed racket angle.
It's 5.
Another game where Wang Manyu is looking to dig deeper still. Invest and look to gain some reward.
6-all.
Beautiful topspin there, just feints it. Into the crossover from Wang Yudi, into the temptation zone, but Wang Manyu knew that. Brilliant.
7-6.
Misses out again there. And this is the fight back. 7 of the last 8 points. The question, of course, this time, can she go on and looks to be building a winning position in this game, make it count, Wang Manyu. Something she wasn't able to do in game 2, that clutch of game points, 2 away from getting a game on the board here.
Ooh, an escape there.
It's
that touch retouch play where there is continuing to be a point of difference between the two.
It wasn't that long. Probably wasn't gonna go along there, but it was high. Not the easiest ball to actually put away there. In all fairness.
Oh, that backhand of Wang Yidi is absolute money.
She comes into it so quickly. It's actually surprising when she plays a slightly loopier, slower ball. Shovel serve again there. Look at that last second kick. Wang manages to trap it, but not well enough. Right into the racket of Wang. Like a praying mantis there. Again, great contact, great rotation on the ball. Very difficult to contain.
Wang Manyu back in the same position that she was in the previous game. 2 game points. Glorious to save the first of them, producing higher levels here, Wang Yidi, when under the pump.
Well, you wonder why we haven't seen it as much. The switch, and then that makes the longest length for Wang Manyu to play cross-court. Wang Yidi knows that, gets the racket high, and creams it right off the bounce. Great angles. Use of angles.
10-all.
And decisive there with the touch. She's been winning the vast majority of the touch play rallies.
So for a second straight time, we go into a 10-all situation. 2-point winning margin needed. The serve alternating. Plenty for Wang Manyu in particular to ponder here. Again as well.
11-10.
I mean, just how good is this? Is it going to be too much for Wang Manyu again? This quality from Wang Yidi.
That time she read the serve well, managed to punch through the top spin. And again, switching Wang Manyu around, especially with this injury, is going to be a real cause for concern for her right there.
Game point, Wang Yidi. Owning the key moments here in this final.
Love one.
It seems like an impossible task. I mean, it would be probably the most heroic comeback in WTT's history if Wang Manyu can come back in the final like this from 3-0 down with an injury. Obviously, Tomokazu Hatamoto did it at the inaugural champions against Lin Gaoyuan, but does it seem as likely here?
Does seem, for all Wang Manyu's incredible fighting spirit, does seem to be a little bit of a long shot at the moment.
Length. 1-all.
I mean, anything is possible on the Infinity Arena. But this would, as you suggest, this would be quite something if Wang Manyu could pull this off from here.
Two all.
Wang Yidi, of course, has to stay focused, stay in the moment. fights that away. So cool, calm and composed again here from the fourth seed.
Comes across the side of that one from the middle. Turns it on again with that switch. Even though the switch is the obvious choice down the line here for Wang Yidi with the backhand, she doesn't want to do it straight away. She wants to keep kind of Wang Manyu guessing as to when it's going to come. Don't want to become predictably unpredictable. Dismissive.
Five.
Yeah. Well described. She's threatening to dismiss the former world champion here, full stop. Only one of their previous six meetings ending in straight games. That was actually their first professional level meeting. It was at the year-end finals in 2019 in Zhengzhou. Man, you winning, dropping a game there. Is the boot going to be on the other foot here?
Looks like it will be.
Seven.
I mean, what a confidence booster this is going to be going into the WTT finals in Nagoya. If I was Wang Manyu, I'd still be happy reaching the final with that injury, especially beating the catalyst Hayata.
But
here, Wang Yidi looking to get a career best result in terms of titles.
She's very close now. 3 points away, and the Frankfurt crowd recognize it. One thing's for sure, this lady will keep fighting. Perhaps mentally the most strong of anyone in the women's game in world table tennis right now, Wang Manyu. But the problem is, for all of that mental toughness, physically, she's had to try and do what she can throughout. She's also, let's say that again, meeting a tremendous opponent here in Wang Yidi.
No one's even taken her to the deciding game this event. She's been that solid.
Seven championship points.
Four, ten.
Despite the injury, this would be a real confidence booster for Wang Yidi, who has had some tough losses this season.
Five, ten.
Grateful for all these championship points. Yeah, predictably does go to the timeout. And the resumption from the timeout. She's still not there yet. You've got to say, though, you've got to applaud indeed both of them for that rally. Whoa.
It's like an arcade game, zipping back and forth. Absolutely heroic, this one man from Wang Manyu.
Championship point number five.
8-10.
Oh my goodness, is it the mark of the devil? She has the serves as well. Oh my.
Will it be number six? That is the one here. That's saved as well.
Nine,
she's got the service here. Oh, if you wanted to know about Wang Manyu, who she is and her grit, her boutique tough mentality. It's right here. One more championship point chance for Wang Yidi. Smile from Wang Yidi, a biting of the lip. Seven championship points have all come and gone. Seven of the last eight here for Wang Manyu. Incredible resolve to take it to tens. And it goes on.
11-10.
Well, we've seen some amazing stuff this week in Frankfurt. If she can go on and pull this game out from the fire, it might just top the lot. First game point, having saved seven championship points, Wang Manyu.
11-all.
This is absolutely jaw-dropping, the resolve. The zen, the ability to stay present. She crashed the birthday party yesterday. Can she crash the comeback?
Another chance to do so now. This is an eighth championship point coming up for Wang Yidi. Will it be the one this time? It is over this time.
13-11.
It is a maiden WTT Champions League.